Hello, dear pupils. I'm glad to meet you again at my English lesson. And our topic for today is presentation. We'll investigate the area how should we prepare presentation for the audience. I will give you some advice and maybe they will be really effective for you while you answer at class. So what is presentation? We have several criteria. It's the process of presenting the content of a topic to an audience consisting of one or more persons. Or it utilizes some visual aid. Or it is generally a PowerPoint file containing all these slides for a given speech like mine. So presentation skills. We have some criteria which we should follow during our presentation. Prepare closing. It should be really suitable, but not just like full working. Next, last two and a half minutes are as critical as first 5 minutes for a successful presentation. So summarize, highlight important points, so the key information, and suggest action, what to do and when, where and how to do it. So you should go straightly to your aim, to your topic. Well, can you see the audience? And can you see the guy? He's making some presentation. Now let's learn how to do this presentation. So an ideal structure for a presentation includes a welcoming and informative introduction. So next one, a coherent series of main points presented in logical sequence and lucid and purposeful conclusion. So you should follow all these criteria in order to succeed while you're presenting. So introduction. So the first part, body, main part, which is informative, we may say, and conclusion, like summarizing some key points. So let's investigate them in a more detailed way. And the introduction is the point at which the presenter explains the content and purpose of the presentation. So this is a vitally important part of your talk, because you cannot just start explaining something without introduction. It's illogical, it's will be so rude, it will be strange, just at least. Well, key element of an effective introduction. So you may say, good afternoon, my name is introduction. And after that, it may be like said, I'm going to explore. So we'd like to show the topic. And after that, I'll be comparing the four main principles or just short plan of your presentation. So after that, you may add some information. You may add some brief information, but do not say everything in your introduction. All the information should be concentrated in your body part. So the main body of your talk needs to meet the promises you made in the introduction. So you should say about everything that you were going to talk in your introduction. If you just exclude something, it's a little bit incorrect. It will be like small mistake. So you will leave some point and it's not so good. So what about conclusion? So regardless of what that goal is, be sure to summarize your main points. So here you are. Without conclusion, you cannot finish your presentation. You cannot just stop speaking, and that means, of course, you should conclude politely. It should be a really pleasant conclusion in order to leave pleasant emotions and feedback about you. So you may follow these tips. You may follow tips which I choose for you. Actually, some of them may be really effective. So say now that it's nearly the end of your presentation, for example. As we wrap up, as we wind down the talk, so you like to reuse it. Or restate the topic and purpose of your presentation. You may say like paraphrasing, you may do some paraphrasing of your presentation. And summarize the main points, which is initial task, important task about you and your presentation. So After all, thank audience for their attention anyway. They were listeners of your presentation. And at the same time, I would like to thank you for your attention. I hope that lecture was interesting. Bye.